regime, they also behaved like that. What you're doing is immoral. You turn me away from a hotel.
Shame
on you.
You
turn me away from a hotel.
A presidential candidate. Katonura Gawa after that.
No, I don't need to beg anybody. I'm a Ugandan, okay? Why do they order me not to sleep in a hotel that I've paid for?
Babugamba, Nabujako, Nabujako, Netumanyan, Tayagara Karuru, Oyenza Kyanga, the Sarabanga, Kom Saja, Kyango Sajo, Nonze, Kubanga. You cannot be a coward as much as this guy is. Because how can he stop us from sleeping anywhere? And we Ugandans, that's one too, but we know that the hotels belong to them. We know that. Now, can you imagine what will happen when we take over power, when they are denying us access to the resources which they have used government money to construct? That is food for thought.
Those are terrible people.
I'm very angry. That is food for thought. Ugandan, all the Ugandans should come up and support us. Oh, anyway, doesn't he see, like the Bible says, doesn't he see that God has rejected him? Doesn't he have eyes? Does he need anybody to tell him?
They are shameless. He's an officer of the law.
Whether he does what, God has rejected him, and a new leader is coming. Whether he wants it. So, I think, I suggest, since we don't have mattresses to sleep here,
We sleep in the cars.
Those who can buy, are there mattresses in this town? And somebody rents us mattresses and put them here, and we sleep.
We sleep.
Yeah.
We sleep on the roadside.
Yes. Since we are denied entrance in any hotel.
Yeah, Ruhanga tells me I cannot sleep here. He's ordered we cannot sleep here. They've closed the door, the road to Masindi. They've crossed the road to Hoima. We decided to sleep here before we go to the next destination. They have ordered that we cannot be allowed to sleep here, whether we have money for the hotel or not. They're ordering every hotel not to host us. Lwaki batuyisanga abatali bannansi? Aba basajja nga bajja bakitaffe bye baayiwawo omubiri. Bakitaffe bye baabasuzanga. Abo babya Ruhanga basulanga mu nnyumba zaffe. Oyo Museveni yasulanga mu nnyumba zaffe. Yalyanga mmere zaffe, yalyanga nte zaffe. Lwaki atugaana okusula mu nsi yaffe? Tukoze ki? Tukoze musango ki? They've closed every road. Enguudo bazigadde zonna zonna. Batugambye temusobola kugenda Masindi. Temusobola kugenda Hoima. Anybody else can, naye ffe tetukkirizibwa. Twaziza musango ki? Okwesimbawo ku Museveni musango.
Yes, wa umulamu nga tumuta. Yes. Yangulu kumantu no nyebya ruhanga.
Yes, all the viewers, like you see, there is a tense situation here.
Right now we are in Mijera. That officer you see there is called Yaruhanga. He is the OC here. He's saying that there is an order. Chagulanyi is not meant to sleep in this area because he didn't apply to sleep here. Yet he paid for a hotel and he paid for a room. He paid for all the facilities. He has been booked into the hotel. But that officer you can see there is rigged. He's saying that he has orders to chase away Chagulanyi. On top of that, they have closed all the roads from going to Masindi, going to Hoima, and Chagulanyi tomorrow has rallies in Chankwanzi. He has rallies in Chivoga and another area. And this could be the easiest place to come from Mijera to go to Chankwanzi and in Chivoga. So the OC is saying Chagulanyi should find somewhere else to sleep, or he has no right to sleep anywhere here in Mijera. So I would like to tell you that Chagulanyi calls this impunity of the highest order, where police officers are just giving orders that Ugandans, especially leaders of the opposition, are not supposed to be using their right to hire any hotel anywhere and sleep, or to use any road. Like you've been seeing during day or during the campaign trail, Chagulanyi's campaign motorcade has always been blocked on the way, and he has been turned away from using main roads, the roads that have been tarmacked by the taxpayers' money. On top of that, he has always been sent to the remote Maram roads, which are impassable, finding himself even reaching late to the rally venues. And on top of that, he ends up not having rallies. Such a thing happened in Chibale, it happened in Hoima yesterday, it has happened in very many other places. Now, the same thing is being brought onto the places where he is supposed to sleep with his team. Yesterday, we were in Hoima, the police and the army cordoned off the hotel. They wanted to send him away. Why? Because they thought they were not comfortable with him sleeping in Hoima. And the same thing is now happening in Mijera here, as he plans to campaign tomorrow in Chankwanzi, Chivoga, and another district that I will be remembering it later. This is becoming impunity, according to Chagulanyi, and he is saying these people should be more understanding, because the Byaruhangas of this world, all the other people from the Western Uganda, all the Bush War veterans have always benefited from their grandparents and grandchildren and grand properties and properties of the grandchildren of the people from Central Uganda, and they should treat them as Ugandans, not as other people who are aliens or refugees in this country. He is saying he is being treated like a refugee or someone who came into this country illegally. Yet,
hello, they have said that we sleep. But for me, I have decided that you all sleep here, just on the ground. But now yes, we can consult the hotel. Let's find a place. If the place is not there, we can still sleep.
Yeah, they know we in Jabu Satu. Era taina buyinza chovola abadde akuba masimu.
Yes, Madame Jole Mugisha, the vice president in charge of Western Uganda, has just talked to the high-ranking officer of Byaruhanga, and she says he has allowed Chagrin to sleep in this area. We don't know whether they had to seek permission. Wherever they will be going, they will be seeking permission so that they can sleep in those areas. However, Chagulanyi apparently has been allowed to sleep in the hotel where he had hired. So we are waiting to see whether he will sleep there without any turbulences or any disturbances from the police officers and the army officers who are trailing him. We have right now like six police patrol vehicles that are trailing us. We don't know what they are up to, but even the other mobile prison is trailing us. Numberless police patrol vehicles are trailing us, so we don't know what is really the motive behind all this. However, like you can see, Chagulanyi said he will be sleeping here if they don't allow him to go to the hotel. He will be sleeping in the vehicle and he will leave his vehicle here. He will be waiting for whatever they have to do. But Madame Jori Echomugashwa said, Jori Mugisha, the vice president of the National Unity Platform here in charge of Western Uganda, has said that they have allowed him to sleep. So we are still waiting. Phone calls are still being made. We are still waiting to see what goes on after here. We are in Mijera. We are in Mijera, the road that leads to Nakasongola, Chiangwanzi, and all those other areas where they expect to go from tomorrow as they go to campaign in those areas tomorrow. Keep tuned to Gero TV. We are still giving you the situation around here where we had branched off to come and sleep.
What did you see? It's coming to my microphone.
What's wrong with you?
If he's not the police officer, what is he doing here? If he's not the police officer, what is he doing here? He said he's not the police officer, what is he doing here? If he's not, what is he doing here? If he's not the police officer, what is he doing here? He's provoking us. He's saying he's not a police officer. If he's a police officer, let him identify himself. Let him identify himself. Nonsense.
Thank you.
I'm looking for Yaruhanga. Yaruhanga, where is Yaruhanga? Where is Yaruhanga? They have surrounded the entire area. You can see supermarket has closed down. They don't allow them to sell things to people.
Now I'm coming down to get network our rooms. But these officers, I think they want to make accountability for the tear gas they are receiving. Because now, for the time we have been here, just denying us an opportunity to access the hotel, creating a necessary scene. Because people are gathering, they are going to be forced to fire tear gas and say, maybe if you are looking for promotion. Unfortunately, there is a gentleman called Biarhan. From people from Ankole, also from Ankole, we are against Bobo and Jaguarani. When we are here supporting him, Jaruanga, Jaruanga, just break off that name, Jaruanga, because you are just tarnishing our name as Banyankole. He's tarnishing our name as Banyankole. Jaruanga, Muronisho Mukorera, because Jaruanga, other than Nigeria, Bobo and Tashmukuna Rara, a hotel and a good shura. Nahenda kwenye shule mire yeye, kuno jang, jarhang kuno jang, ya bobo wa natajamano. It is very unfortunate. It is very unfortunate. Konga, I want to tell Ugandans that it is not true that all Banyankole are against the Bobi Wine is big. Yes. Ankole has spoken.
This is the Yaruhanga man. Was blocked. Yaguranyi from sleeping.
Good work, man. We are Yaruhanga.
Yes, we want to tell you that police is causing chaos itself, it's causing tension in this area. You can't tell why. They have surrounded the entire area. They're treating other candidates as enemies of the state. Whoever opposes President Museveni becomes an enemy of the state. And yes, indeed, Kyagulanyi has been turned into an enemy of the state. Yaruhanga is making continuous phone calls, endless phone calls. Like you can see, the guys have surrounded the entire area. We are just waiting to see what happens. Maybe we're gonna sleep here, or we shall be going to the hotels to sleep. Like father always sings. Kama wali osola. Everything is possible when God is there. Yes, this entire team is Honorable Chagulanyi's team. The people are standing by the roadside to view what's going on. They have not crowded here. They're just wondering why Chagulanyi would be treated like this.
Banange nkubulire wano wetuli twakoba banange nkubulire wamma wamma
baba
banange nkubulire
omuganda wa
banange
Let's go for the September.
We shall be coming back, our dear viewers, with an update, but just know for now that's where we're standing. We're still here. Shall be giving you an update on what's the final decision on this standoff.
Gobya Ruanga, Colabia Gala, Ninja Colomanian, Tinobot, and Aye Sabuatu. Okay? During the Obote regime, they also behaved like that.